Hi guys, my name is David from Pay It Forward.
And I'm David from Pay It Forward.
And in this video, we're going to explain why your iPhone gets hot, and then we'll show you some ways to fix this problem for good.
Right.
So first of all, why does an iPhone get hot?
Well, to understand why, you have to understand which part of the iPhone gets the hottest, and that is the CPU, or the central processing unit. Now, the CPU on an iPhone, or the processor, is designed to go from 0 to 100. So think about this, though. If you're driving in your car, you can put the pedal to the metal. That's okay to do for short periods of time. But what if you put the pedal to the metal and just held it there for minutes? Your car engine would overheat and you'd probably have a problem. Well, that's what happens when iPhones get hot. Usually the CPU of your iPhone gets revved up to 100 or somewhere up there and gets stuck there. So we're just gonna go through and figure out different ways that that would happen. One of the most common reasons why is that one app has sort of hijacked the CPU and it's just going in the background. Even if you're not using it, there's something wrong with the CPU and it's just going and going and going.
It's going again.
It's getting hotter and hotter. Okay, so we're gonna close out the apps, right?
So how do we do that? Well, we double click the home button.
Right, this is kind of a, you know, first step. We're just going to close out all of your apps. And if you've never done this before, David will show you how to do it.
Double click the home button, activates the app switcher. You'll see all the apps you have open.
Yep.
Simply just swipe them up off the top of the screen.
Right.
And when they're no longer appearing there, that means they are closed.
Right. And that doesn't delete any of the data in the apps. When you open them back up, everything will be fine. It's just kind of like closing them on your PC. So the next step in the process is we're going to try to figure out which app was causing the problem. There's a couple ways to do this, and the first one is the scarier way. We'll dive into the iPhone analytics data to look for some problem apps.
So, and that is within the settings app?
Mm-hmm. We'll open the settings app, and then we're going to go down to privacy, and then scroll all the way to the bottom of this window, and tap on analytics, and then tap on analytics data.
So what should they be looking for here? There's a lot of letters and numbers, and it's a little bit tricky to understand.
Right, so I don't expect anybody to be able to read complex iPhone logs, but all I want you to do is scroll through this list briefly and see if you see the name of one app repeated over and over and over again. Now, you also might see something called latest crash. And if you see latest crash and then the name of an app, you know that that app has a problem.
Well, I don't see any latest crash. I'm assuming my iPhone is super healthy.
Your iPhone is very healthy and it's not very hot, which is good for you.
So we check the analytics data. What's next?
So the next thing we're going to do is also just another way that's a newer way to look for problem apps is we're going to look at which apps are using the most battery life. Because imagine this, if your iPhone CPU is revved up to 100%, then that app is going to burn through your iPhone battery. So let's open the settings app again, which we're still in, and we're going to go down to battery. And then under battery usage, your iPhone will display a list of apps that have used battery within either the last 24 hours or the last 7 days.
Yeah, you can toggle back and forth. It's pretty simple.
Yep. So all we're going to do here is look for apps that are using battery too much. So it's okay. If David uses Safari a lot of the time to surf the web, it makes sense that it's going to use a lot of data.
For sure.
If there's some app that you hardly ever use and that it's using like 50% of your battery, it's a problem with that app.
That's the problem.
Yep, and that's why your app
is. And then what should they do then?
They should probably uninstall the app or check for updates.
So we've just checked our battery settings for problem apps. And the next thing we're going to do is check for app updates, which is one of the reasons why your app might be malfunctioning. And we're just going to go out of the settings app and into the app store.
Mm-hmm. Out of the frying pan and into the...
And then you just want to tap the updates tab at the bottom of the screen. There's a little arrow and a little square. Mm-hmm. And when there's an update available, there's usually a number. It'll say how many are available. And as you can see, I have one. Mm-hmm. That is the Bitmoji, create your own personal emoji app. It's kind of fun.
Yep.
So what you can do, either tap update next to the one app you want to update, or you can just tap update all. This is great if you have multiple updates. It'll save you, you know...
Literally seconds of your day.
Seconds of your day. A few taps, you know.
So you know, actually, some people might have like 80 apps.
They might have a ton of apps to update and 80 taps. That's, you know, 30 seconds.
Yeah, literally minutes of your day.
So that's updating right there. You can see a little status ring.
Right. So similarly, iPhone software updates, the main software, can solve problems with apps that cause the CPU to overload and your iPhone to get hot. So how do we check for software?
Well, let's go back into the settings app. Mm-hmm. And we're going to scroll down and tap general, software update, and it's going to check for an update. Now, if update is available, it'll say the name of the update, what features are being added, and then it'll say download and install. You can just tap that. Mm-hmm. If your iPhone is up to date, it'll say whatever your version number is, your software is up to date, which mine is.
Okay, so let's say you've done all this stuff, your iPhone's still getting hot. And you know, really, this is going to solve a lot of problems. A lot of people are going to just have the problem fixed by closing out their apps. And you know what? We should add one. Let's just turn your iPhone off and back on again.
Oh, okay. Well, if we do that, I'm going to lose my screen recording.
Okay, well, let's turn my iPhone off and back on again. My iPhone.
Your iPhone.
My iPhone. Let's turn it off. Okay, so I'm going to press and hold the power button until slide to power off appears in the screen. Then I'm going to use my finger to slide across the screen and wait for my iPhone to turn off. Now, a lot of people get confused because as soon as they do that, they try to hold the power button and it doesn't turn back on and uh-oh, right? But the truth is that even though there's nothing on the screen right now, it takes like 10, 15 seconds for your iPhone to turn all the way off. So we've pretty much talked through that.
Yeah, wait 30 to 60 seconds and, well, then, you know, just to be conservative, you know.
Yeah, wait 30,
You never know.
Yeah, okay.
Especially if your iPhone is that hot, you got all those programs running, it might take a
while. Right, I need to cool off, put it in the fridge.
Yeah.
All right. Don't freeze it though, that could be bad.
All right, so we've done our software updates. We've done our iPhone restart.
Right.
We've checked our apps and analytics and battery. Still a little hot? Okay.
You know, I just want to mention one thing real quick about the battery life. So hot temperatures can actually damage your iPhone battery permanently, so it's a good idea to get this problem solved. However, cold temperatures will not damage your iPhone battery. Your iPhone battery will drain, but as soon as it warms back up again, you'll be able to use your iPhone. But nobody watching this video is having that problem. So moving on, we're going to reset all settings.
All right, so we're going to go back to the settings app here.
Mm-hmm. We're going to go back to General.
General.
All the way to the bottom.
Scroll down to the bottom and tap Reset.
Mm-hmm.
And then you get a whole bunch of resets here. The one you're going to want to do is Reset All Settings.
Mm-hmm. Reset All Settings is kind of a magic bullet that fixes a lot of problems. Not every single problem, but it does fix a whole lot of problems on your iPhone. David's not going to do this right now because it would be kind of an inconvenience for him.
You're going to enter your passcode.
Yeah.
Then you're going to get a confirmation alert that says Reset.
Right.
And then you're going to tap it. And I think your iPhone restarts after you do the reset, right?
It sure does. Yep. And that, you know, it does solve a lot of problems that are sort of hidden in the background. Little software problems can accumulate with time and that'll, you know, fix them. Now, imagine your iPhone is still hot and, you know, none of this stuff has worked. And probably most people by this point have fixed their iPhones. But we're going to have to do something more drastic.
We're going to have to do the DFU Restore.
DFU Restore. No, it's not DFU Restore. It's a DFU Restore, which stands for Device Firmware Update.
And we have a great video on this. Mm-hmm. We'll link to that in the description of this video. But before you do a DFU Restore, you should definitely try to back up your iPhone.
Yep, using iCloud or iTunes, preferably iCloud, because iTunes can have some issues with iTunes backups. But make sure you do that, because a DFU Restore is just going to wipe everything off your iPhone.
So that's it for this video. That is why your iPhone gets hot and how to fix the problem. We thank you for watching. Leave us a comment down below if you have any other questions. Mm-hmm. Feel free to give us a thumbs up if you found this video helpful. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for the best iPhone content on YouTube.